Are you ready for the latest concern popping up on computer screens? Well, it is called text neck.
And before you laugh, know that it could carry some serious consequences for you and especially your kids.
You see it in parks, at ball games, schools, and shopping malls. Essentially, anywhere there are people, there are cell phones. And many teenagers more or less live on them. We've all heard about social concerns from kids spending too much time online. But now it turns out too much texting can literally be a pain in the neck.
That's the normal curve that your body likes, with your head balanced on top of your spine.
Dr. Jim Rogers is a neurosurgeon at Tulsa Spine Hospital. He says the average human head weighs around 9 pounds, but bending your head forward changes your body's dynamics.
Bioengineers have determined that the head weighs 20 pounds when you're forward flexed 15 degrees, and it weighs 40 pounds, stresses on your back, when you bend 30 degrees forward.
At 45 degrees, a prime texting position, your head is putting almost 50 pounds of pressure on your spine. A chiropractor in Florida first came up with the term text neck to describe the problem, and now has a whole institute devoted to what he calls a global epidemic affecting millions.
So you're gonna stand up nice and tall.
Mark Bearden of Sky Fitness and Well-Being isn't quite so dramatic, but says he frequently sees the effects of text neck on the young athletes he trains.
When did you first start noticing this as a trend?
When I started dealing with some younger athletes here at Sky, and I started noticing that their ability to keep their spine neutral and their ability to extend their hips, they were limiting, and they all were going in the C pattern.
And remember, these are athletes he's talking about, kids who are motivated and physically active, kids like 13-year-old Tara Hall.
Show me some of your trophies.
Most of these are my softball ones right here.
She's a very, very hard worker.
I got offensive player of the year.
And yet, when it comes to technology, there's a problem.
Come home, you've got TV, you've got, you know, however many 400 channels. You've got Netflix, you've got the iPad, you've got the cell phone in your lap.
Tara admits she feels the effects on her body.
Sometimes my lower back's like not flexible or like aches sometimes.
Diagnostic testing in January placed the blame for those back problems right here on this little device.
Were you surprised?
Yeah, kind of, because I never thought that, like, it would happen to me.
This will help strengthen your trunk.
Mark Bearden says for athletes like Tara, the problems associated with text neck can have a direct correlation to performance.
They don't run as fast when they're playing their sports. They don't jump as high. They're more prone to injury. Walk it back in, okay?
But it's not just an issue for athletes, or kids for that matter. Adults are seeing the symptoms too.
Generally, it affects when they sit in a car. It affects them whenever they're reading a book. It affects them even at their job, because it can cause some chronic neck pain, cause some chronic headaches.
Well, this is our normal neutral position.
Dr. Rogers says it can even affect lung capacity and may ultimately require surgery.
But I would think if you're starting at a younger age being like this, you're setting yourself up for some future problems.
No question.
Dr. Rogers says some simple isometric exercises to stretch your neck can help your body regain its natural balance. It's also important to be aware of your position when you're texting or playing games. Try to keep your head up. Just a little effort and awareness can make a lifelong difference.
I see patients all the time that come in and say, well, I wish I'd have known this was going to happen to my spine. I'd have taken better care of myself. Well, now it's a chance for young people to hear about this and maybe take some proactive steps that might lessen their problems in the future.
Now, as for Tara, Mark Bearden says, just after a few months of training, he's seeing a big difference in her and her fitness. We've had the two of them demonstrate three basic exercises to strengthen your core and improve your posture. You'll find the link inside this story. That's at newson6.com.